is normally how I do it. This is how I would do it myself or pricing something on stream for somebody. We look at the stats and then we try to get something similar. Now, when I say similar, you need to have the values as much less. Like, I can't search for these exact values. I'm pretty confident I wouldn't find anything. So we're going to search for 30 to just any resistance. We're going to search for 20 chaos, because this, the chaos roll, that's very important. People really desire that. We're going to search for 50 life, and we're going to search for physical damage, and we're not going to say what kind of physical damage or how much. It's very important when you're doing this, there are two categories in PoE XYZ. There's pseudo, and then there's actual. Pseudo, I didn't think I'd have to define pseudo for anyone, but pseudo means like, or anything that makes up this that comes close. So for instance, pseudo life includes strength, because strength gives you, for two strength gives you one life. So if I did pseudo 50 life, I could have a ring with 40 strength, which would give me 20 life, and a 30 life roll. That's crap. That's a crap ring, in my opinion, because if you're paying for the strength on the ring, you want at least 50 or 60 life. Then you get a lot of life for those two mods put together. And again, this is where we talk about the sum of the parts versus the parts individually. Some of the parts can be worth quite a bit. Perhaps 35 strength and 50 life by themselves aren't great mods, but together we have something that's valuable. So now you put the value that you want as the minimum bracket to the left. Again, we're just going over everything. If this seems very simple, well, okay. It's a good review. Chaos resistance, we're going to do 20. Okay, now I'm going to talk about this. With elemental resists, you want to do pseudo, because you don't want to define the resist. Like, if I search for ring with 41 lightning, that narrows it to an unbelievable degree. But if you search for pseudo resistances, that covers anything. So it could be 41 cold, 41 fire, or all res, which counts times 3, so like 10 all res, that'd be 30. And say 15 cold, that satisfies searching for, say, 30 or 40 resistance. So this is the key one. Pseudo plus the total elemental resistance. So for this particular ring, I'm going to do 30. Depending on how many results come up, if, like, say a lot of results come up, you can start inching upward in your values so you get to there's less like it. This helps you define a range for the item. Now, most items have more elemental resistances. For instance, let's just say 60. This would have another, like, let's say this rolled with 41 fire, so it was defined. That hurts it perhaps a little bit, but man, 82 resistances plus chaos, these are very strong rolls, considering the maximum amount of resistances you can have on a ring is 45 times 3, even really with all res, because 16 all res is 16 times 3, and you could then have two primary rolls like fire and lightning. And so it adds up to be 135, basically, ever. Plus, of course, the base of the ring. That's, again, why two stone can be more valuable to a certain point. Now, with the physical damage, where it said pseudo physical damage, well, that's because an iron ring has physical damage as the base, so if you did pseudo, you'd get some iron rings in their rolls, which I don't want, because I don't think iron rings are very valuable at this point in the game. So let's just see what comes up. This is live right now in the game. I'm not going to search by who's online. Got to make sure you select the right league. Now, mostly, if you open this again, if I open this tomorrow, it'll have Beyond. I don't search in Chrome often. I use Firefox. Okay. 25 results, and this is good. I did not pick rings, so we're getting quivers and gloves. Now, this, you never want to search like this, because they're just different items. Gloves and rings can't be compared. They have different mods and different roles. Click ring. Six items like it. So you see as we go through, there's a sapphire ring, which I think is one of the less, not quite as valuable bases. You can see that some, this one has been mastered on. He has it up for 1.5x. Now, this one person isn't indicative of the market, right? That's the thing you have to realize. That doesn't mean that this is what you should price your item at. It's just you can see what people are pricing at. See how this one's 4.5x? This is mine. I found my ring. Now, I'm looking at, now when I search for things, I think six days ago when I alked this ring, I alked like three or four crazy rings in the same day. I had a whole bunch of rings like this that were really good, and I priced them between 3 and 5x. A bunch of them have sold. Now, I think this ring was better than one of the ones that sold, but yet that one sold quicker. I can't tell you why. I don't know what's in the mind of someone else buying the ring. Now, maybe I need to lower this price. I haven't adjusted or looked at the market again. When I searched with these exact stats a week ago, there were no rings for sale like it. Now, we can narrow this a little bit more. For instance, if I did 40, okay, we lost one ring. And you can see that this adding on of 9 resists plus the base, this gets them... You do pseudo elemental so you can see it. If I didn't do pseudo elemental, some of these wouldn't show up. So like for instance, this one, this is a bad fizz roll. All attributes really isn't helpful. Even though it's not bad, it isn't helpful. 3 energy shield is bad. So this has some bad rolls and they still want 7 chaos for it. This one here, 1.5x, this is in my mind more appropriate. Mana regeneration is very valuable, although maybe not on a fizz ring. 21 chaos is great, energy shield's fine, and they mastered on already. I haven't mastered anything on. Someone who looks at my ring knows they can master a suffix on. So now this ring, I think, is very comparable to mine. Bramble Coil. 4 all attributes, unfortunate. The 8 fire res, also unfortunate. This doesn't have a buyout. Open his link, probably wouldn't tell us anything. If he had it in a featured tab, tells you a little bit more. It means he thinks his thing's valuable, yours is similar to it, so maybe yours is valuable too. He just does use procurement. By the way, procurement, best program in the world. If you're not using it, install it, use it. There are plenty. I would make a video about procurement, but Willy Wonka's made a video, Ziggy D's made a video. Don't need me to make a video about procurement. So I'm gonna have to revisit my price. Again, when I search, very general stats, nothing came up. It means either rings like it had been sold recently, or they weren't indexed, or I don't know. I still think mine's more valuable than all of these rings, except this one, perhaps. But again, this has a bad roll. Nothing about my ring is a bad roll. It's me. If this was top fizz, wow, that'd be crazy. So it has medium fizz, everything else is a good roll. That's pretty rare to find in Path of Exile, to be honest. And again, a master suffix slot. Maybe I should put 10 all res. Maybe that's the best way to get this indexed and someone to buy it, because people might be searching for chaos with 50 res. And they're not finding my ring because it only has 41. But if I put 10 all res on it, well, all of a sudden this ring has 71 res. Now, there are people with Elrion level 8. So it's a week ago, there was virtually no one in Beyond with level 8 masters. I mean, maybe no one. Now there's like 10, 15 people with it. So it's a little easier to get a mod off a ring. So it's probably worth it. In fact, let's just do that right now. Take this ring. It has a suffix slot. I'm just going to put all res on it. Okay? All res. Now it's 7 to 10 on the roll for 2 alks. Clearly worth it if you think it's worth multiple X. Now maybe I'm wrong about the multiple X thing. I mean, someone might be like, oh, you're a streamer, you're just trying to get a value. If you've seen me or watched my stream, I alk a lot of stuff. I'm not just like, oh, all my rings are worth 5x. This particular one is a good ring. I've alked a lot of garbage, too, and I just vendor that. I'm not going to waste my time or your time. I don't want to waste time. I want to sell stuff. So maybe this is only really worth 2x, and that's fine. I price things much higher for a little while just to see what's going on. I've had one or two whispers about the ring, so to me that means I'm probably wrong in the price, and I knew that. But that's okay. I'm gonna put the all res on. I'll probably make it 3x buyout, 3.5x buyout. I do 3.5x. I always try to do that for something valuable because I expect them to be, how about 3x or how about 2.5x? Or let me give you some equivalency. And yes, they're equivalent, quote unquote, but I don't really want 30 scours. I might take it because maybe I'll use them at some point, and I think it's smart to take items, take equivalent currencies if you can get a good ratio, if people really want your item. But that has to be factored into your pricing. So let's put all res. Let's hope I get a good roll. And we got dumpstered. But that's okay. It's still 24 to our resistances. So now this ring is 65 resistances, which is a bracket I think people would search. 50, people tend to do round numbers, 50, 60, 70. So I think it'll show up. I need to reload my procurement now because I've changed some stuff around and everything, and then re-index it. So, just a short video that I made, although it's probably ended up being very long, about jewelry. I hope you've picked up something from what I've said. I didn't really go into certain mods being worth, say, 3 chaos, and then these four mods together, you go 2, 3, 3, 4, and then you get a value of 12 or whatever. I don't really think that's how pricing works. It's a little bit more of an art to it, which, of course, that's what really douchey people say to be like, oh, you can't understand this because there's, I've got something up here that you don't have. I'm not saying that. What I'm saying is that familiarity with pricing and pricing in general will make you a better pricer, no matter what your knowledge base of PoE is. If you see more items, you'll get more familiar with what's valuable for different classes, or excuse me, different specs, everything. So thank you very much for checking out the video. Follow if you want. I think I have it flashes to subscribe to my videos. I do stream on Twitch almost every day. If you want to come watch me doing various things, that'd be great. And so thanks for checking out the video.